Have you ever sat back on maybe your ministry or your participation in a local church or doing something on the web, and maybe you were sharing with your family or talking about your past, and you kind of got this idea that it was so much better then than it is now, that you were somehow more spiritual or more alive unto God than you are now, or somehow you were better than what you are now? Did you know that the closer, and this has been true of a lot of born-again Christians, as well as what Paul said in the scripture, that the closer you get to God, the less you feel like a Christian, and the closer you get to God, the more that you realize what a sinner you are, and that as you continue to live and let God live inside you, then you recognize daily how sinful a person you actually are, because God brings from the inside of your heart, inside in here, to the outside, the things that are ugh. So you may not have known how much corruption was going on in you until God brought it out of you and dealt with it on the outside that you can see today. So sometimes what you thought of as being so beautiful as a little baby is looking beautiful and wonderful and doesn't look like a sinner until you put two babies together and you put something in between them and watch how they fight to get to it. There isn't the normal tendency of a baby or a child in a sandbox to share unless they're taught it, because the first thing they do is me, mine, and I want. So don't think that because you don't feel like a Christian today, or you don't think that you're making progress, that you aren't. In fact, the more that you think you aren't making progress, it's probably a good reason to recognize you are. But God can speak to you directly and share with you where His heart is at, because He loves you and He wants to tell you what He has for you. And that's why we share devotionals, because it's not always about doing or becoming or, you know, thinking you're off on your own, but it's about realizing you're in a journey with everyone else together, that we're all coming to a place that Jesus is making us one in the body, one in the Lord, and one in faith, and one in love with God, so that we can learn to love each other. Because I know looking at you and you looking at me, gets a little tough to love each other, doesn't it? But that's the destiny for you and I, and all those who call upon the name of the Lord. In Spurgeon, "Oh, that I were as in months past," from Job. Numbers of Christians can view the past with pleasure, but regard the present with dissatisfaction. They look back upon the days which they have passed in communing with the Lord as being the sweetest and best they have ever known. But as to the present, it is clad in a sable garb of gloom and dreariness. Once they lived near to Jesus, but now they say they feel that they have wandered from Him, and they say, "Oh, that I were as I was in the months past." They complain that they have lost their evidences, or that they have not present peace of mind, or that they have no enjoyment in the means of grace, or that the conscience is not so tender, or that they have not so much zeal for God's glory. The causes of this mournful state of things are manifold and many. It may arise through a comparative neglect of prayer, for a neglected closet is the beginning of all spiritual decline. If you pray not, you have not, because Jesus said, "Ask and you shall receive, that your joy may be full." Or it may be the result of idolatry, that you have placed something else in the place of God. The heart has been occupied with something else more than with God, and in a world of distraction, the attractions are many, and it's easy to get the focus in the wrong place. The affections have been set on the things of earth instead of on the things of heaven. A jealous God will not be content with a divided heart. He must be loved first, foremost, always, and best. He will withdraw the sunshine of His presence from a cold, wandering heart. Or the cause may be found in self-confidence and self-righteousness. I'm okay because I'm doing it my way. Pride is busy in the heart, and self is exalted instead of lying low at the foot of the cross, knowing that in me there dwelleth no good thing. Christian, if you are not now as you were in the months past, do not rest satisfied with wishing for a return to former happiness, but go at once to seek your master. Talk to Jesus, ask God, and tell him your sad state. Tell him how you feel. Tell him where you're at. Tell him what you think. Ask his grace and strength to help you walk more closely with him daily. Humble yourself before God, and he will lift you up and give you yet again the joy and the light of his countenance. Do not sit down to a sigh and a lament and say, oh, woe is me. I would that I had which I had before. While the beloved physician lives, there is hope. Nay, there is a certainty of recovery, even for the worst of cases. Whenever you think that you are not good enough, just remember, God is always able enough to listen to what you have to say, and he cares enough to share with you his heart, which is more than able to take care of all you may feel or say. Because he loves you, he chooses to open up to you what he wants for you today and always, which is to know his love and grace and mercy for you in a very special one-on-one way, so that you'll never feel lost or gone astray, but that you'll always feel confident and competent for each day that you live in this world as well as in eternity to come. Thank you.